Today I'm going to show you how to use the duplicate stitch to add designs, letters, or patterns to pieces knit with circular knitting machines. In today's example, I'm going to show you how to add a heart to a pair of mittens and a hat. If you enjoy this tutorial, you might also like my pattern books, Circular Knitting Machine Patterns Volume 1 and Volume 2, both available now on Amazon. The duplicate stitch is a simple and fun way to personalize your knitting. I use the stitch in many of my patterns, such as my Halloween goodie bags, Christmas tree ornaments, and Christmas stockings. You can find all these patterns and many more in my Etsy shop, which I'll link below. The hat I'm using in this tutorial was knit with the AddiExpress King Size Knitting Machine, and it's a simple hat knit with 115 rows. The mittens were knit with my Family Sized Mittens pattern using the Child Size Small, which is also linked below. The duplicate stitch is very common in hand knitting, and it works very similarly when using the technique with knitting machine pieces. However, because many knitting machine pieces are knit in the round and are double layered, I'll give some tips later in the video that are specific to working with circular knit pieces. If you make this project, please tag me on social media when you share your work. You can find me at Diana Levine Knits on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and Pinterest. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to stay up to date when I release my latest videos. Let's get started on the duplicate stitch. Step 1 is designing your pattern. Before beginning to use the duplicate stitch, you can either follow a pattern or you can design your own. For the hearts shown in this tutorial, I've designed a simple heart, but you can take graph paper like the chart shown here and design your own pictures, letters, or patterns. When designing your chart, it's important to first identify how many stitches and rows are available to design with on your work. For example, before I designed this heart, I first counted the stitches and rows where I'd be adding the design on top of my mittens. I found that the mittens are about 11 stitches wide, and I counted about 15 rows where I wanted the heart to be located. Then I went to my computer and designed a chart that's 11 sections wide and 15 rows tall. That ensures that whatever I design will be able to fit onto my knitting. Next, I simply filled in any sections where I wanted to add a stitch to the design. Now that our design is complete, it's time to get started with the stitching. Step 2 is reading the chart. The next step of working with the duplicate stitch is knowing which way to read the chart. Personally, I find it much easier to use the duplicate stitch when working left and right or bottom to top. I find it more challenging to use the duplicate stitch when working top to bottom. So anytime I read a duplicate stitch chart, I usually begin with the bottom row and work the first row from left to right or right to left. And when I finish that row, I then work the second row from the bottom and then the third row from the bottom until I reach the top. However, in some patterns, such as the letter M, I would first work bottom to top on one leg of the M, then the diagonal lines, and then from bottom to top on the other leg. As you begin to use the duplicate stitch, you'll find which ways you prefer to work. Step 3 is planning the location of your design. Before beginning the actual stitching, it's important to locate where on the work you'd like to add your design. For this hat, I'd like the heart to be centered on the front of the hat, and I'd like it to begin a few stitches above the brim. So before I get started, I'll first count from left to right to identify the center of the hat, and then I'll add a stitch marker to identify both the center of the work and also the row where the brim hits, so that when I pull the brim down, I know where to begin the heart. I've already added the hearts to the set of mittens, and now I'll add the heart to the hat, and the instructions will be the same for both pieces. Step 4 is using the duplicate stitch. The goal of the duplicate stitch is to fully cover one of the stitches from your original piece of knitting with a new length of yarn in a different color. Before we begin, it can help to look at the knit stitch up close. For each stitch, you'll see that two bars form the V-shape. Where those two bars meet, at the bottom of the V-shape, there's a hole at the bottom of the stitch where the bars are emerging from. And directly above the stitch, you'll see the next stitch above it. We'll need to know both of these locations in order to work the duplicate stitch. To work the stitch, cut a very long length of yarn in the color you'd like to use for the design. I usually err on the side of longer rather than shorter. Secure the yarn on the inside or the back of your work on an interior bar. Next, thread the yarn through to the front of the work and exit the yarn through the hole directly below the stitch you'd like to cover. Gently pull the yarn through. Here's the stitch that I'm planning to cover with this duplicate stitch. To cover this stitch, thread the yarn from right to left through both sides of the V-shaped stitch directly above the stitch you'd like to cover, and pull the yarn through. Make sure to pull the yarn very gently. It's important with the duplicate stitch not to pull the yarn too tightly, because if you pull too tightly, the stitch will look too small and won't cover the entire stitch, which means that you'll end up seeing through to the original color. You want the tension of the duplicate stitch to be slightly less than the tension of the original stitch, so that it fully covers the original stitch. After you've pulled the yarn through gently, the next step is to thread back through the hole directly underneath the stitch you're covering, and pulling the yarn through very gently. If you're only adding one stitch, you would now thread all the way through to the back and secure the yarn with a knot on the back or the inside. However, if like in this design you'll be working multiple stitches, you'll thread directly to the next stitch, without threading all the way through the back. When working with circular knit pieces created with circular knitting machines, you'll often be working with a piece that's double layered, which is great for the duplicate stitch because the center layer creates a place for the yarn on the inside. For this design, I'm only working one stitch for the bottom row, so after finishing this stitch, my first row is complete. To begin the second row, I'll thread directly through the first layer of knitting to the hole underneath my next stitch, which will be the stitch furthest to the right on the second row. As you're threading through, make sure only to thread through the first layer of knitting and not the second layer. This will make the back of the duplicate stitch hidden within the two layers of knitting. Pull the yarn through gently. Next, we'll repeat the exact same process as the first stitch, exiting out below the stitch, and then threading right to left through both halves of the V-shaped stitch directly above the stitch you'd like to cover. Pull the yarn through and then thread back through the hole directly below the stitch, threading directly to the next stitch in the pattern. We'll repeat the exact same process again, exiting out below the stitch, then threading from right to left through both halves of the V-shaped stitch directly above the stitch you're covering, pulling the yarn through, and then threading back through the hole directly below the stitch, exiting underneath the next stitch in the pattern. You'll see I've now completed the first two rows of the heart. To finish the heart, simply continue to follow the pattern from bottom to top until you reach the last stitch of the design. As you're pulling the yarn through the second half of the stitches, you may find it helpful to place a finger over the first half of the stitch while you pull the yarn through to make sure you aren't pulling the first half of the stitch too tightly. When you reach the end of your design, thread back fully to the inside or back of the work, secure the yarn with a knot, and weave the yarn tails into the center layer of the work to hide the yarn tails. You can remove the stitch marker and flip the brim up. The duplicate stitch heart is now complete. To review, here are some of the important tips to remember. 1. Follow the charts from left to right and bottom to top. 2. Don't pull the yarn too tightly. Pull very gently, leaving enough yarn to fully cover the stitch below. 3. You may want to place a finger over the first half of the stitch while you pull the yarn to cover the second half of the stitch. 4. When working with circular knit pieces, take advantage of the double-layered knitting by threading through the first layer, but not the second layer, when moving on to your next stitch. Once you learn the duplicate stitch, the possibilities are endless. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please check out my Knitting Machine pattern books, Circular Knitting Machine Patterns Volume 1 and Volume 2, both available now on Amazon. And you can also find my patterns in my Etsy shop linked below. If you make this project, please tag me at DinaLevineKnits on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and Pinterest. And if you liked this video, please give it a like, comment below, and subscribe to the channel to stay up to date with my latest patterns and tutorials. Thank you.